and that we have such a beautiful, although very, very cold day today. Looking ahead for the weather, still not determined to give up with us at the moment. There's a small depression coming down out of the Great Lakes at the moment, and they're saying that we're going to have fresh southwesterly and then northwesterly winds between here and New York. But of course that's not very far away now, so I don't anticipate it'll be causing us too much problems. One thing I would like to mention, ladies and gentlemen, those of you that watch Channel 3 on the television, I do apologize for the crazy angle of the camera, making us look as if we're flying along on one ear at the moment, which of course we're not, we're nicely upright, but the camera, along with other things, has suffered a bit in the wind and has become loose on its mountings, and hence it lying over at a bit of an angle. Other things around and outside the ship, well, we're passing down now, we've passed Sable Island to port and the Nova Scotia coast on our starboard hand. We do see a few fishing boats around. If you're out on deck braving the cold, do keep an eye open. You may see one or two of them. But equally, I would say again, do be very careful when you're out on deck. There is some ice there, and as the temperature is still very low, the ice is taking a long time to go away. Well, ladies and gentlemen, sadly, this is the last time I expect to be talking to you, but it has been a great pleasure having you with us on Queen Elizabeth II on this crossing from Southampton to New York, and we look forward to you travelling with us again in the not-too-distant future. For those of you that are continuing on with us from New York tomorrow, well, you'll have a new captain. Commodore Ridley is joining the ship. I'm proceeding on leave tomorrow, going back to England, and Commodore Ridley will be your captain for the run down the coast and through the canal and up to San Diego and then across to Honolulu. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I'll hand you over now to Stephen with the information for noon today. And once again, my thanks for travelling with us on board Queen Elizabeth II, and come back soon. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you, Captain Woodall. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. This is Second Officer Stephen Clark with today's noon position and weather information. Our position at noon today was a latitude of 43 degrees, 12 minutes north, a longitude 63 degrees, 30 minutes west. The weather at noon was as follows. The air temperature, minus 2.1 degrees centigrade, that is 28 degrees Fahrenheit. The sea temperature was 8 degrees centigrade, that is 46.5 degrees Fahrenheit. The barometer was reading 1008.2 millibars and rising. The wind was west-northwesterly, force 4, which is 14 knots, and we have a slight sea with a low swell. The weather ahead of us in New York for tonight is clear but very cold, with temperatures in the mid-20s. Tomorrow promises to be sunny but still cold, with temperatures reaching the low 30s. Since noon yesterday, we have covered a distance of 672 miles at an average speed of 26.88 knots, and our total distance covered since leaving Southampton is now 2,544 miles at an average speed of 27.59 knots. The nearest land to us at present is the coast of Nova Scotia, which lies 70 miles to the northwest. Our present course is 236 degrees true. This takes us down to Nantucket Shoals, which we shall pass at 10:30 tonight. From there we head into the Ambrose Light and the New York Pilot Station, where we shall arrive at 5 o'clock in the morning. For those of you up early sightseeing tomorrow, we shall be passing the Verrazano Narrows Bridge, which connects Staten Island to Brooklyn, at 05:50. At 06:10 we shall pass the Statue of Liberty on our port side, and after that you'll be able to see Manhattan Island on our starboard side before we reach our berth at 7:30. Thank you for your attention, and enjoy your day aboard the QE2.